Burn investing is one of my favorite investing strategies. I am even using this strategy right now with one of my properties. If you have never heard of this method, then it may blow your mind. Burn investing helps to grow your investment portfolio, net worth, and cash flow at an accelerated rate and keeps as much, if not all, of your capital still in your bank account, allowing you to buy an investment property with little to no money out of pocket. Welcome to the channel. For those of you who don't know me, I have been investing in real estate for 3 years now. And this year, I decided to actively show you how I am growing my investment company. Everything from what my day looks like to how I'm buying more and more real estate. If you are just starting out or don't even know how to get started, the cool thing is that I'm not that far away from where you are at. So technically, it's entirely possible to follow what I'm doing and potentially catch up. I even dare you to subscribe, get involved with our journey, and let me know when you surpass my portfolio. Let's get straight into it because the Burr method is the primary way that I'm actively growing my portfolio. Like I said, I have one going on right now that I am really excited to go into detail, and once the whole process is complete, I'll tell you how I found the property, how I funded the deal, what it cost to purchase and rehab, and the costly mistakes I made along the way. Today, I'm going to explain what the method is, what type of properties to look for, how to fund the deal, and what the results are once it's all complete. What does BRRRR stand for? It's an acronym that stands for Buy, Rehab, Rent, Refinance, Repeat. This term was made popular by Brandon Turner from Bigger Pockets. If you are just starting out investing in real estate, you will want to really pay attention to this strategy because if done correctly, you will have zero money in the deal, unlike the conventional 20 to 25% down method. So if you are on a shoestring budget, this is the go-to method for you. Let's get into the first part. This is the most important part, the buying the property part. You need to find a property that is a good deal. What is a good deal? Well, a house below market value is considered a good deal. Most of the time, it's a property that needs to be rehabbed, often called fixer-uppers. You will need to actively search for these properties. Ways to do that is get connected to local wholesalers, real estate agents, ask your friends and family if anyone is selling their house. If you're just starting out, the best method though is driving for dollars. I have a video about driving for dollars and some other deal finding methods, so be sure to check that out. Do whatever you can to find properties. Once you find a property that needs to be fixed up, how do you know what it is worth and how much to pay for it? To find that information, we need to determine its market value when it's all fixed up. This is often called the ARV, or after repair value. What is the ARV? This is the top price that someone will be willing to pay for the property when it's all fixed up. This is vital that you understand what this means. To put it as simple as possible, the market determines this number. Even if you believe your property is worth $600,000, the market doesn't care. If you went ahead and listed that property for $600,000 and the market determined it was valued at $300,000, your house would be sitting there for years before ever getting an offer, even if it was in perfect condition. I'm gonna drill this point again just to make sure it sticks. Let's take a Monster energy drink as an example instead of a house. If I had a can of Monster and brought it to you, the market, and said, buy this one energy drink for $45, you would simply say no. Why? Because you know you can go to the gas station and get the same product or similar for under $3. So how do you determine the ARV? With experience, you'll be able to do it yourself, but if you are new, I would rely on experts. Not Zillow or Redfin estimates. Reach out to either local realtors who specialize in investment properties or a local property manager. They are great assets to use for two reasons. One, they come with experience and information that you need, and two, they know other investors in your area that can help you in the future. They both want to earn your business, so work with them and cultivate that relationship. They both will provide you with excellent information and data to find out what the property you have identified can be worth. So what's the magic discount number? The number that's typically thrown around is 70% of the ARV minus the repair costs. Let's use real numbers to show this. A house is worth $100,000 when it's all fixed up. It currently needs $10,000 worth of repairs, so you would need to purchase it at 70% of $100,000 minus $10,000. This would equal $60,000. You may ask yourself, why would anyone ever sell their house for $40,000 less than what it's worth? That's a great question, and there are many reasons someone needs to sell their house at a discount. Here are a few reasons: divorce, loss of job, financial hardship, job relocation, inherited property, tax liens, bankruptcy, tired landlords, and much more. Then they come across the next issue. The majority of people need loans to buy houses. Well, loans have restrictions. Because they're taking a risk lending you money, they want to make sure you are buying a house that is worth the risk. A fixer-upper typically falls into the more risky category for lenders, so even if they listed on the MLS, most people wouldn't be able to afford the house anyway. So now they're stuck. That's where we help, but we also have an issue. Most of us don't have the cash to buy the house. The banks won't lend to us because it's in poor condition and we don't have the 20% down for the conventional mortgage. So how do we fund the deal? This is where you can get creative. The go-to method would be to find someone with the cash, partner with them, and split the profits. Don't be afraid to split the profits because a slice of pizza is always better than no pizza. Don't be afraid to share, especially if you can't do the deal alone. Maybe you don't know anyone with money like that, and that's okay. I'll do a future video talking about finding those people, and you may be surprised how easy it is to find people that have money. So what's the next move? Short-term financing. These loans are more costly upfront, but are less restrictive. The best people to contact would be hard money lenders that are active in your market. Hard money lenders typically work with private investors that don't mind a higher risk factor for bigger returns. Essentially, they know the rich people that you don't, and they act as a middleman to fund your deals. It may sound a little complicated, but go talk to multiple hard money lenders to see their costs, how they operate, and what their terms are. Get to know them, and they will be a great asset to your investment career. They are more expensive than typical lenders, but very, very valuable. So now you can buy the property, but you still don't have money to fix it up. $10,000, where do you get that? Well, hard money lenders will typically lend 100% of the fix-up costs. This is where they make a large portion of their money. I know that starting point is lengthy, but the buy part of the BRRRR method is so vital. You need to make sure you buy the property at a discount, 70% of the ARV minus rehab costs. So now you're in. You own the property. What is next? Well, rehab it. Buy, rehab, rent, refinance, repeat. Find multiple contractors and build a relationship with them. Have them come out to bid the property, decide who fits in your budget and who is best suited. Cheaper is not always better. Reach out to local real estate investors on your local investor Facebook groups. They will have the best references. Then once you have your contractor picked out, get them to start working on the property. Now you have a property that is all fixed up. You have funded the deal using hard money. What's next? Rent. List your property up for rent and get it filled for top dollar. Make a good listing. Take nice pictures so it attracts the best renters. Once rented, then it's on to the next R, refinance. Go to a local bank or a local lender. Tell them you have this fixed up rental and want to refinance into a long-term mortgage. This is where the magic happens. Let's take the previous numbers. We found a property we know would be worth $100,000 when fixed up. We bought it at $60,000, put $10,000 into it. Now we're all in at $70,000. Well, the local lender is going to get an appraisal on your property. The value should be close to your number $100,000 because you did your homework before the purchase. The lender will then tell you how much they will lend on the property. Most banks will lend up to 80% of that property. So you get a loan of $80,000 to pay off your hard money lender, which you owed $70,000. The other $10,000 is to pay yourself back for the closing costs, holding fees, and other payments you incurred during that time. If everything went smoothly, you should have the same amount of money in your bank account as when you started, a fixed up cash flowing property on a long-term loan with a tenant paying for it all. And for the bonus, you increased your net worth by 20% of the property's value. Maybe that last one didn't click, so I'll reiterate it. You own a property valued at $100,000, but only owe $80,000 on it. So in this scenario, your net worth increased by $20,000. So now, repeat the process, right? BRRRR, buy, rehab, rent, refinance, repeat. Do it again and again and again using the same amount of money as many times as you can, increasing your net worth, cash flow, and buying more properties. A lot of people will have concerns about what if something goes wrong during construction and it costs $12,000 instead of $10,000. Or maybe the refinance comes in at $98,000 instead of $100,000. Not to be harsh, but so what? $2,000 to gain monthly cash flow plus $20,000 of net worth, that sounds like a good loss to me. Not only that, but next time, just make sure you run your numbers better. It comes with experience, and $2,000 is a pretty cheap education compared to a $200,000 degree that locks you in a 9-to-5 that you hate and only pays you $60,000 a year. I'm just saying. I appreciate you sticking with it till the end. I love helping people grow financially, especially through real estate. I'm looking forward to showing you an in-depth of our BRRRR investment currently going on. Make sure to show the channel love. I can't wait to see you in the next video.